It's never too early or too late to work towards being the healthiest you. So let's get going with week 12 of your yoga class. Sukhasana, probably the easiest and the most comfortable of the meditation postures to start with. It facilitates mental and physical balance without causing strain or pain. With practice and as the knees get closer to the floor, the ease of the posture improves. Sit with your legs straight in front of the body. Bend the right leg and place the foot under the left thigh. Now bend the left leg and place the foot under the right thigh. Place the hands comfortably close to the knees. Palms facing down or in Gyan Mudra. Keep the neck, head and back upright and straight. Slowly close your eyes. Relax the whole body. Slowly open your eyes to the beauty around you. Many experts now recommend planking over crunches or sit-ups, since planks put less strain on your spine and hip. Plus, a plank will tone your back, glutes, hamstrings, arms and shoulders at the same time. That's a lot of gain for just 60 seconds of pain. And now for the fitness attitude to cultivate this week. Increasing the reward chemical or dopamine is the secret behind increased motivation, focus, and alertness in children. This chemical can easily and naturally be increased by eating certain fruits like bananas and nuts, regular exercise, including mindfulness and meditation, cultivating an interest in music, and a good night's sleep. Palms, wrists and elbows together, stretch up as much as you can. Now slowly, keeping the palms together, bring the hands down. Once again, palms, wrists and elbows together, stretched as high as you can go. Open out at the elbows and bring the palms down together. Now to strengthen the neck muscles, move the chin to the right and over the right shoulder if possible. Then slowly move the chin to the left and over the left shoulder if possible. Repeat, chin to the right, over the right shoulder and chin to the left, over the left shoulder. Now let's also do half circle rotations for the neck. Forward rotation, right to left, left to right, one more time, right to left, and left to right. Let's do the backward rotation, right to left, come back, left to right, repeat one more time, right to the left, and left to the right. Now let's stretch for a healthy spine. Cross the arms, stretch to the right for a few seconds, move to the left, hold the stretch for a few seconds. Repeat, stretch to the right as far as you can go and stretch to the left and hold the stretch for a few seconds. Now to activate the internal organs a little more, twist to the right, hold the stretch. Come back to the center, twist to the left, hold the stretch for a few seconds. Repeat, twist to the right, hold the stretch for a few seconds. Come back to the center, twist to the left and hold the stretch for a few seconds. Now for the final stretch, sitting firm, rotate the upper body clockwise two times. Feeling maximum stretch and anti-clockwise two times. Once again, feeling the complete stretch on the upper body and the spine. Now raise the hands up, interlock the fingers, stretch the hands, extend the right foot, pull the toes towards the body and try to stretch over the toes. Come back, stretch up once again. With a full spine stretch, stretch forward and try to bring the interlocked fingers ahead of the toes. Now let's repeat for the left leg, stretch up, left leg stretched, stretch forward and try to come ahead of the toes. Stretch up, stretching forward, come down and try to hold the toes inside the fingers. Chair yoga increases flexibility. The ability to bend, twist, stretch and move freely is more important. It improves strength and uses our muscles to complete certain otherwise difficult yoga poses. Thus, the stress and pain of traditional yoga can be considerably reduced. Keep the palms together, slowly stretch up. Continue to keep the palms, wrist and elbows together, completely stretching upwards. Stretch up, hands parallel, bend forward, stretch the spine, keep the fingers and toes in one straight line. Lift the right knee, look up, arch back. Now try to touch the chin over the knee. Once again, place the hands down next to the toes, stretch the spine. Now look up. Stretch backwards, look down, stretch again, feeling the stretch in the lower back, interlocking the fingers, raise the right knee, arch back, stretch back, chin to the knee, slowly place the leg down, stretch, hands parallel. Stretch and arch backwards, join the fingers, wrist and elbows and brings the palms down together. Now for the left leg, stretch the hands up, palms, wrist and elbows together, hands parallel, stretch, arch back, slowly stretch forward, lengthen the spine, place the fingers and toes in one straight line, lift the left leg, arch back, stretch the spine backwards, bring the chin to the knees, over the knees if possible. One more time, stretch, bend forward, hands and toes in one straight line. Look up, arch back, backward bend of the spine. Look down, stretch and bend the spine forward. Take the left leg up once again, stretch and arch back, bring the chin to the knees, Slowly raise the hands parallel with a full backward stretch and backward arch. Join the palms, wrist, elbows. Bring the hands down in Namaste. Kenan wrote waving flag originally for Somalia and the aspirations of its people for freedom. Today the song is to remind all children that you are braver than you believe and stronger than you seem. So let's check how many of those stretches you remember.
drill down. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation all around us.
Singing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game. And together at the end of the day, we all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a Wavin. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a Wavin flag. So wave your flag, now wave your flag. Now wave your flag, now wave your flag. Now wave your flag, now wave your flag.
Today, let's learn Utkatasana, another everyday asana. The way you kickstart your mornings is very important because it dictates the rest of your day. Utkatasana is the perfect asana to power up your mornings. Regular practice increases balance, focus and determination. Here's how to do it. Keep both feet parallel and 1 foot apart and the hands on the sides of the body. Focus your eyes on a point straight ahead. Now stretch out your hands parallel to the floor and palms facing downwards. Raise your heels and go up on your toes. Slowly lower your body to the floor in squatting position and press your calves. Once comfortable, slowly rise up and go up on your toes once again. Now lower your heels to the floor and lower the hands to the sides. Now let's look at the side profile to understand the asana a little better. Keep both the feet parallel and 1 foot apart, hands on the side of the body. Focus your eyes on a point straight ahead. Stretch your hands parallel to the floor and palms facing downwards. Raise the heels, go up on the toes. Now slowly lower the body to the floor in squatting position and press your calves. Once you're comfortable in this posture, slowly rise up, go up on your toes once again. Lower your heels to the floor. Lower the hands to the sides.